Welcome to Microsoft Virtual Academy. I'm Brandon Matherson, and I'm a product marketing manager at Microsoft on the Windows Server System Center and Data Center Solutions team, focused on delivering a data center solution and management suite for customers to deliver a better service to their end customers or individual business units. Our topic today that I want to touch on is IT service management and bringing together the solution and learnings from ITIL V3 and MOF, Microsoft Operations Framework, to our System Center 2012 R2 suite of products. And primarily this is going to live within Service Manager. So let's dive into what we're going to be delivering and how does this play in a broader story of our management solution on top of Windows Server 2012 R2. So you may have learned, you already may have heard, we've talked about infrastructure provisioning and taking advantage of Virtual Machine Manager and how we deliver that solution and provide expanded capabilities beyond just building out the infrastructure with storage, compute, and networking. We've talked about infrastructure monitoring, taking advantage of Operations Manager and having insights into how my infrastructure is performing, understanding where my resources may reside and what the health of that environment may look like. We then take the next step with application monitoring or application management and still building on insights within Operations Manager to give more depth in decision-making process to application owners. Then we have automation and self-service where we dive into the automated tasks of managing processes with Orchestrator or with Service Manager. And now we're thinking about how we're building out ITSM processes based on ITIL within Service Manager itself. We also have Windows Azure Pack, and that's taking the next step on top of System Center 2012 R2 and delivering an on-premises infrastructure as a service solution to customers. So let's dive into IT service management. I want to give an overview of where we are and how we deliver this service to customers. So the agenda for the IT service management track is going to be a deep dive into SLA insights and analysis, or thinking about how we're going to provide more data, more reporting insights and intelligence for our technical decision makers to make better decisions. Then we're going to think about how do we standardize service delivery, and that's based on a lot of the management processes that we're most familiar with. And then how do we manage those processes? Incident management, change management, release management, or even the SLAs. And then we have OLA insights and analysis. And this is where IT is taking an inward view of how do we provide more better data to make better decisions about what services we need to provide back to the infrastructure or back to the enterprise across the varying business units to make sure we meet their needs. So that's kind of the focus that we'll touch on between each of the segments within this particular topic. So, but at a high level, that's just level set in terms of IT service management. There's a number of things that we think about when we want to provide a flexible service delivery model back to the enterprise. And IT is seeing a lot of demands coming from the business units. A number of things across how do we enable self-service publishing and consumption of IT services? How do we integrate people, process, and knowledge into our technologies? And then how do we have an efficient resource utilization and management of that data and provide that reporting insight back to the enterprise? How do we do that? Well, within R2, we want to do that through enabling self-service requests for cloud capacity. And we see that a number of ways: service offerings, request offerings, and the service request templates. That's basically the shell of how we actually deliver that service to customers. And we take advantage of the cloud service process pack and the additional add-on to Service Manager to be able to do that. We then have an industry standard service management and process workflows, taking advantage of Orchestrator with all the workflows, as well as the CMDB or the Configuration Management Database with Service Manager. And then we want to make sure that we top this off with a rich set of business and operational insight reporting that helps us to be able to get all the way down to VM level metering or SLA reporting and understanding our costs versus our solutions through a chargeback scenario. So that's kind of how we see IT service management meeting the needs of what those demands are across a number of different areas for delivering services. So let's look at the Microsoft Data Center Service Management architecture. We may have seen this in a number of different forms, but let's take the processes at a high level. Those processes that are key across the stack that enterprises are being challenged with meeting are release management, change management, making sure self-service experiences are embedded there, reporting and insights, as well as incident management. Orchestrator automation coupled with service manager is going to provide a process to be able to do that. We're going to see a service catalog and workflows, each coming from orchestrator and service manager. Then we have, on the right side, we have our templates, which empower all of those elements of the service catalog. We take advantage of the data warehouse and the CMDB information, work items, configuration items, and knowledge-based articles that we can now build on, as well as knowledge around what is the health and what has been the process and steps that we've applied to existing issues that have occurred. All of this can be rendered through the self-service service manager portal, as well as app controller in a number of different ways, or even Excel and SharePoint to deliver that rich reporting. All of this is done by being able to deliver a holistic view of connecting each of the components within the enterprise. Those components may be system center, or they may be other third-party tools. That's perfectly okay. But that integration layer between system center, Windows Server, and third-party management tools is what brings together a better view of the enterprise management stack. So we want to make sure that we drive service management outcomes. And what are those outcomes that we're being targeted with meeting? Is data center management, forecasting, data insights. So we want to make sure that we're looking forward in terms of what are the demands and what are the needs in the future. We want to make sure that we're providing a cost savings because we're able to bring down the cost of overhead, reduce errors, there's costs associated with errors, and being able to manage multiple solutions within the environment can become quite challenging as well. So we want to make sure we provide a more consistent view into the environment from a number of different angles across the stack. That's going to be achieved by bringing in integration, integrating across the stack, and being able to ensure that we simplify the tasks and that we introduce governance and reduce risk and make sure that we have compliance in place. The CMDB helps us do that. Process automation is the key. Next, we have our business unit and its users and our tenants. Let's call those tenants, who we need to make sure that we provide a unique and flexible choice of options based on the needs that they have so that they can still perform and be productive in their respective units. Next, we want to make sure that we provide efficiency, and that's going to be done by reducing that downtime, providing more services, and being able to reduce that cost that IT has been consistently chartered with as we provide more resources or physical resources. Now we can really automate this and virtualize those tasks. That makes it much more simpler for IT to deliver those services on time under those SLA thresholds. So that's the overview of what we mean by IT service management. So as we march forward, we encourage you to take the additional segments within that tool set, and that will fall under the SLA and insights, or look at the processes and automation and managing those processes, and looking at the OLA insights and analysis as well. But to finish this up, we want to make sure that you get your hands on the software, go into the download center on TechNet, and download System Center 2012 R2 and try out Service Manager. We want you to go in and evaluate online and play with some of the TechNet virtual labs that we've created. We have unique scenarios that we've built out there for you, so we want you to take a look at that and build that out. And lastly, of course, come back to Microsoft Virtual Academy. Continue to take the segments on IT service management, and as well as explore the other System Center 2012 R2 capabilities. Again, my name is Brandon Matherson, and I look forward to you coming and joining us soon. Thanks again.